Many times you want multiple conditions in a query. If you want to use multiple conditions in multiple fields, the placement of your arguments will determine the Boolean relationship between those arguments. For example, if a criteria is on the same line, it is automatically considered an AND. If the criteria is on a separate line, it is automatically considered an OR. For example, let's say I want to write a query to list the first name, last name, and amount for all clients who paid $250 or more, or made payments of less than $75. On this screen, I have two QBE grids. I have two examples for you. The first example on the left-hand side of the screen, I show the criteria of greater than or equal to 250 under the amount field, or less than 75 under the amount field. Because the criteria are on separate rows, that means it's an OR scenario. If the payment amount is greater than or equal to $250, or the payment amount is less than $75, then the record will display in the Dynaset. On the right-hand side of the screen, I'm doing the same thing, only I'm using the keyword OR. If I have multiple criteria, and the multiple criteria are in the same field, I can use this keyword. Notice I have a relational operator, and I have a numeric value. You don't put quotes around them. The OR is a keyword, so you don't put quotes around that either. If you run this query, the Dynaset on the bottom right-hand side will display. Let's look at an example of an AND. Write a query to list the first name, last name, amount, and payment date for all clients who paid more than $100 on or after 3/3/2008. I'm using two fields here. The first field is the amount field. I'm checking for greater than 100, and the payment date field, greater than or equal to 3/3/2008. Notice under the criteria row, they're on the same line. So now I'm checking for this and this. So if it's greater than 100 for the amount and the payment date is on or after 3/3/2008, the record will display in the Dynaset. And there is an example on the bottom right-hand side of your screen. Here I'm looking for a range. Write a query to list the first name and last name of all clients who made payments between 1/1/2008 and 3/8/2008, inclusive. Notice under the criteria row, under the payment date field, I have between pound 1/1/2008 pound and 3/8/2008, and pounds surrounding that number. Pounds surrounding those numbers means they're date fields, same syntax criteria. Our criteria syntax as we learned before, but we're using the keyword between and the keyword and. No quotes because they are keywords. So we're looking for a range here. If you run this query, the Dynaset on the bottom right-hand side of your screen will display. Let's look at compound criteria. Write a query to list the first name, last name, amount, and payment date for all clients who paid more than $100 on or after 3/3/2008 or made a payment of $100. So I have an AND scenario. If the payment is greater than 100 and it's on or after 3/3/2008, they're on the same line. Look at what column they're under. So if it's this and this, or they made a payment of $100. So if they made a payment greater than 100 on or after 3/3/2008, or they made a payment of $100, then the record will display in the Dynaset. And there is the Dynaset in the bottom right-hand side of your screen, or on the bottom right-hand side of your screen.